Hi, my name is Peter Biro. I am a classified Kiswahili teacher. I'm based in Nairobi. I offer private classes. I can reach you in your office, your residential place, or any place convenient with you. You can reach me on telephone numbers that appear on the screen. Kindly subscribe, share, like for more video updates. Thank you. Hello. Welcome to our today's class. You remember in our past lessons, we had discussed about how to do the greetings. And again, we talked about self-introduction. This will be a continuation of the other lessons, but today we are going to cover a very vital part of the language that will make you now be able to construct sentences and speak. Now, in our last lesson, I introduced two verbs which were very vital. That is the verb itwa, which was be called, and then we also had the verb toka, which was come from. So itwa is be called, and toka is come from. Now today we are going to introduce another verb, very beautiful verb if you like. Verb is penda. Penda. Now verb penda means like or love. We use that verb to mean the two ways, like or love. It will be love if you are, the context will always give out what you mean, if you love or if you like. Now, remember the format I gave you, and I'm talking about the subject prefixes. Subject prefixes, or I would call them subject pronouns, that is I, you, he, she. Now, ni, I told you, is I. U is you. A is he or she. And tu is we. Tu is we. Is you all, like you plural, you all, you plural. And then wa is they. So you have ni, u, a, tu, wa to represent I, you, he, she, we, you all, and they. This is all you need to conjugate and make sense in your sentence. So just like we need ninaitwa, unaitwa, anaitwa, or we had ninatoka, unatoka, anatoka, we came to plural, tunatoka, mnatoka, wanatoka. Now in this sense, we shall do the same with penda, which is like. You only need to have ninapenda. Ninapenda. That's I. Unapenda. Unapenda. Then you have anapenda for third person. Ninapenda, unapenda, anapenda. Then you have tunapenda. Tu. Tunapenda. Then we have mnapenda. Mnapenda. And then we have wanapenda. So it's ninapenda, unapenda, anapenda, tunapenda, mnapenda, wanapenda. This ni u a, then two, if we are two of us or more than one person, and then I would say m, if you all m, then I would refer to wa for they. So you end up having ninapenda, unapenda, anapenda, tunapenda, mnapenda, wanapenda. I would make a sentence like ninapenda Kenya. Ninapenda Kenya. Ninapenda Kenya. To mean I like Kenya. So for anything that you like or you love, this is how you say it. Ninapenda Kenya. I would say unapenda Kenya. I would say anapenda Kenya. If it's two of us, I would say tunapenda Kenya. I would say mnapenda Kenya. Or I would say wanapenda Kenya. Now, we have covered now three verbs, itwa, toka, and penda. And the main thing I'm trying to emphasize on are the subject prefixes. But again, you ask yourself, we have this in making a sentence, like in Kiswahili, we have, you see, we have ni, na, penda. But if you look at it, this is the verb, this is the subject prefix. It is three things in one. We have like three things in one to make sense. Now you have ni, which is a subject prefix. Then we have the na. Na here plays a very vital role. This is the tense. Na is the tense. Then we have the penda, which is the verb. And then your conjugation is done. So na here represents the present or the present continuous tense. So any conjugation you do with the na tense, you're talking about the present. Like if I say ninaitwa Peter, ninatoka Kenya, ninapenda Kenya. So I'm talking on the present. So the whole thing is ni na penda. So in any conjugation that you do, you will always have the subject prefix. You have the subject prefix. You have the tense. Then you have the verb. So what you have here is the tense. Sorry. What you have here is the subject prefix plus tense plus verb. So the STV will form your sentence. So you say nina penda, nina itwa, nina toka. Now if all that you need now is to have the verb and make sense. Okay, now as you can see, I have only introduced to you the verbs itwa, toka, penda, but this is in their stem form. These are verb stems. Now, like in English, we have to as the infinitive for English verbs. Like you say to go, to cook, to sleep, the two. Now, equivalent to that in Kiswahili, we have infinitive ku. So ku is the infinitive for Kiswahili verbs. So we shall, instead of itwa only, we shall have ku itwa. We shall have ku kuitwa. Now it's gonna be to be called. To be called. Kuitwa will be to be called. Now. Then we have kutoka. Kutoka will be to come from. Then we have kupenda. Kupenda will be to like or to love. So, as we continue, I'll now be introducing to you the verbs with the infinitives. Ku, like to in English. Now, for that case, I have other verbs that I want us to try to practice on, maybe try to conjugate. Now, always when you conjugate, the infinitive drops. The infinitive will drop when you're making a sentence or constructing a sentence. So let's see. Let's look at the verbs and the board. Now, I have the verb kukaa. Kukaa. Kukaa au kuishi. Kukaa au kuishi. Kukaa au kuishi. This is to stay. To stay, or use the same to mean to live. To live, to live. Kukaa. Then we also have the verb kusema. Kusema. Kusema is to speak or to say. To speak or to say. Kujifunza. Kujifunza. Kujifunza is to learn. Like to learn Kiswahili. Kujifunza. Kusoma. 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 Kusoma is to read or study. We use that verb to mean to read or to study. Kusoma. We also have the verb kufanya. Kufanya. Kufanya is to do. Kufanya is to do. To do. Then we have kufanya kazi. Kufanya kazi. Kufanya kazi is to work. But literally it means to do work, which is to work. So, to work. Kufanya kazi. Then we have kulala. Kulala. Kulala is to sleep. Then we have the verb kupika. Kupika. Kupika is to cook. So I want you to try and do the conjugation. Let's take the verb kukaa. Kukaa, just like other verbs that we have tried, we have used, you have like ninakaa. Kese ninakaa. Ninakaa. Se unakaa. Unakaa. Anakaa. It's easy. Tunakaa. Mnakaa. Wanakaa. Ninakaa. Unakaa. Anakaa. So just like we had ninapenda, unapenda, anapenda, tunapenda, mnapenda, wanapenda, you have ninakaa. Unakaa. Anakaa. Tunakaa. Mnakaa. Wanakaa. Like I would say, Ninakaa Nairobi. Ninakaa Nairobi. Ninakaa Nairobi. Unakaa, I would ask you, unakaa wapi? Again, unakaa. Wapi. And I think I told you, wapi is the interrogative to mean where, where. Unakaa wapi. Like, where do you stay? Where do you live? You can ask, unatoka wapi. I think we shall also try to review the interrogatives like I had given you. Just to remind you, remember we had interrogatives like we started with nani, then we had gani. Remember we had unaitwa nani, au jina lako ni nani. We also had gani, which was habari gani. Then we now have wapi, which is where. So we shall also try to see. Or work on as many interrogatives as possible because they lead us to the right answers. Now, you can ask somebody, unakaa wapi? Unatoka wapi? The other verb that I want us to use here, again, is kaa, kukaa au kuishi. Kukaa au kuishi, which is to stay. I'll say, ninakaa. Ninakaa au ninaishi Nairobi. Ninakaa au ninaishi Nairobi. Then I would ask you, unakaa wapi? Unakaa wapi? And now, wapi is interrogative to mean where, like where do you stay? Ninakaa au ninaishi Nairobi, I'm staying in Nairobi. Unakaa wapi, where do you stay? And then I think I also talked of other interrogatives like nani, where we used or we had the question, unaitwa nani, au jina lako ni nani. We had gani, where we just said habari gani. Gani means which, then wapi means where. So nani is who, like who, jina lako ni nani, who are you called, barigani, which news, and then we have wapi, which is where. Also want to introduce a word here, which is very important. The word is katika. Katika means in. The preposition in, or it could also mean at. Then I would say, katika Nairobi, katika Kenya. Sawa sawa. Then I would ask you, katika Nairobi, unakaa wapi? Katika Nairobi, unakaa wapi? I would use the same katika to ask you, katika Kenya, unatoka wapi? Katika Kenya, unatoka wapi? Then this will also now make you have more details about somebody. Katika Kenya, unatoka wapi? Na katika Nairobi, unakaa wapi? Okay, let's also have kusema. Kusema, I hope you'll have the opportunity now to conjugate, use this verbs and maybe go get more verbs and do conjugation in the same format and you make sense. Kusema is to say or speak. I'll say, ninasema Kiswahili. Ninasema Kiswahili. Ninasema Kiswahili. Ninasema Kiswahili. So it's ninasema, unasema, anasema, tunasema, mnasema, wanasema. The conjugation is just done the same. Kujifunza is to learn. Say, ninajifunza Kiswahili. You can also say, ninajifunza Kiswahili. Kufanya is to do. And now, with this kufanya, I want you to have it, to use it in different occasions, in different situations, to get to know more verbs. Unafanya nini? Unafanya nini? Because, of course, you have ninafanya, unafanya, anafanya, tunafanya, mnafanya, wanafanya. I'll repeat this so that you get to understand well the subject prefixes. So you will find somebody doing something, especially the kids. They are good at giving information. He's playing or he's doing something. You can ask the kid, unafanya nini? Unafanya nini? If the kid was cooking, the kid would say, ninapika. Unafanya nini? If the kid was sleeping, the kid would say, ninalala. Unafanya nini? If the kid was reading, then the kid would say, ninasoma. So it's just like, use this phrase to make you get more verbs. Nini? Nini? Again here, it's a new interrogative. Nini means what? What? Unafanya nini, like what are you doing? Unafanya nini? What are you doing? So then you can have nina soma, nina lala, nina pika, whichever. How about if you want to ask somebody about other guys, people there, that person plural, you can ask wanafanya nini? Wanafanya nini? Maybe you're coming into crowd and you see some people doing some funny things over there. You want to know? Then you ask, wanafanya nini? Then if they are cooking, somebody will tell you, wanapika. Wanapika. So just remember to change the subject prefixes to fit into the person you're referring to. Whether it's first person, second person, third person, it could be either singular or plural. Then you just prefix the subject prefix on a conjugated tense, verb. You conjugate the verb and it makes sense. And I hope that will be very easy for you to do as you continue learning and using many verbs as possible. Now, let me have the verb kufanya kazi also. I'll say, ninafanya kazi. Ninafanya kazi. Ninafanya kazi. And that is, I am working. I am working. So it would be ninafanya kazi, unafanya kazi, ninafanya kazi, unafanya kazi, anafanya kazi, tunafanya kazi, mnafanya kazi, wanafanya kazi. Basically, you just need the verb, then you get the subject prefix, you remember the tense, the not tense, you are talking about something happening now or something that happens, then you conjugate. So, also in this sense, I would ask you, unafanya kazi wapi? Unafanya kazi wapi? Then, like, where do you work? This could be, where do you work or where are you working? Then somebody will ask you, ninafanya kazi katika Nairobi. I work in Nairobi. How we can just say ninafanya kazi Nairobi. And that would make sense. And I hope with this, you enjoy the lesson. Kindly ask to subscribe, share, and like for more video updates. See you in the next lesson.